Well, there could finally be a buyer for the old Moulin Rouge property just north of downtown.
The company that operates bars all over town has thrown its name in to take it over, bringing new attention to the site that's seen its fair share of failed redevelopment attempts. 8 News Now reporter Shakayla Alvarenga explains why some say this one could work.
Well, Brian and Denise, Nevada Restaurant Services operates Dottie's, an already successful chain right here in Nevada. And many people believe they are a strong potential buyer for this site.
It's a fascinating story, a story that is told not only just in Las Vegas, but throughout the entire United States of different communities that have risen from nothing into something. And so we need to ensure that that message is never lost.
What was once a diamond in the rough.
So the Moulin Rouge opened in a climate that was, you know, way before its time. And it was shut down because of that.
The Moulin Rouge has been gutted by fires in recent years. Hopeful buyers made promises they couldn't keep.
No time to dwell on the past. You know, there's a recession that we came out of.
Councilman Cedric Creer remains optimistic that Nevada Restaurant Services will buy the property.
It's a very well-established company. If I had to guess, they're probably very well-funded, which means that they could build a project if they so chose to do it.
While it's unclear what the site could be, we do know one proposal.
We don't have any casino owners in the West Side. So shift bosses, casino managers, all of those high-level jobs that are happening in the industry are not held by our people.
Catherine Duncan wants to turn the land into a casino and gaming training facility, a place where the future will be shaped.
The spirit of the community is ready for a redeveloped Moulin Rouge.
And the council will also have the ability to waive almost $2 million in civil penalties imposed on the land. Reporting live at City Hall tonight, Shakayla Alvarenga, 8 News Now.